While aspiring to be AWS Cloud Architect, getting AWS certified can be the best thing to get started with. But most of the beginners in this journey are clueless about which reference materials to study from and what are the common experiences while preparing for AWS Solution Architect Associate exam. Now you'll get to know answers to most of these questions in this video. So let's get started. Welcome to my channel SkillPhilip, and in this video, you'll get to know what is the difficulty level and exam details of AWS Solution Architect Associate exam? Then what are the recommended study materials, both from AWS and other websites, that is the course, the tests, the blogs and the books which you can refer? Then we will go through the study pattern, that is the exam preparation pattern which I have created just for you, so that you will be in a position to prepare for this exam or appear for this exam in at least 7 weeks. And last but not least, I will be motivating you by giving you some tips to prepare for this exam. So let's get started. AWS Solution Architect Associate exam sits in the middle of the difficulty level hierarchy, wherein it is more difficult to crack than Cloud Practitioner exam, but it is quite easier to crack than professional and specialty level exams. One more thing I would like to tell here is, if you are someone who is not having any prior experience on designing solutions and architecting, then I would really recommend you to have experience on these areas before you move ahead to appear for this exam. Please refer to the last section of which AWS certification is right for me video for more details. Talking about the exam details, the passing marks for this exam is 720 out of 1000 marks. The time limit for the exam is 130 minutes, where you can add extra 30 minutes in the exam by applying benefits called as English as a second language. The details for this benefit can be found on AWS website. The cost for the exam is $150, where you can get 50% discount if you have cleared any AWS certification previously. The format for the exam is multiple choice, wherein you can either select single answer or multiple answers depending on the question. And the exam delivery type is either you can visit the testing center or you can give the exam from your home, that is online proctored exam. So the materials required to prepare for the exam can be divided into two parts, one from AWS and one from other websites. So AWS provides the exam guide, the courses, tests and white papers and FAQs. We will try to understand the details of each material on their website. So let's have a look. So we are on the AWS certification preparation exam page, where you can see the study material for various AWS certifications. So for the AWS Solution Architect Associate exam, we have this materials provided by AWS. So let's have a look at the exam guide. This is the exam guide provided by AWS, which gives you the details about the topics which are important with respect to exam. It also gives you many details about the passing score and about the domains which are really important and what are the subdomains or the topics which are important for the exam. Also, it provides some sample questions. There are the 10 sample questions provided in this PDF, and they can really help you to get started with your testing to check your knowledge for the exam. Moving ahead, it also provides us the AWS learning paths which are recommended, and they also provide us some video lectures which you can refer for prepare for the exam. Then these are the white papers and FAQs recommended, and I would really recommend you to go through them so that your concepts are really clear for the exam. These are also important with respect to exam, as some of the concepts provided here can be asked in exam. Then you can take the exam readiness training, where there is a classroom training, free digital training and a webinar as well. you can always go ahead and take a free digital training to get an idea about how the exam would look like. And you can always take the practice exam. This practice exam is for $20, but you can get it for free if you have previously cleared any AWS certification. So the difficulty level of this exam is really high and the questions are around 20 to 40. So I would recommend you to give this practice exam before you actually appear for your final exam. Now for the study materials recommended from other sources, you can always refer to the courses provided by Stephen Marek or A Cloud Guru. You can find these courses on udemy.com and I personally find them really helpful. They really help me to clear my concepts for the exam. Then you can refer to the Jayendra Patil's blog and blogs provided by AWS. The book which you can refer is AWS Certified Solution Architect Official Study Guide. This can again really be helpful to you if you want to read the concepts and appear or prepare for the exam. Also for the hands-on, you can create your free tier AWS account or you can go to the quicklabs.com where they will help you to do hands-on for the specific given time, that is for either half hour or 1 hour. And for the tests, you can refer to the websites like WizLabs or the practice tests provided by John Bosco and Dan Cronenberg on Udemy. You can also refer to the other courses on other websites, but I personally found these tests to be really helpful and they are really difficult ones. They will actually help you to prepare for your exam, where you can learn from your weaknesses, from the incorrect answers you get, or improve your concept. Then if you want to refer some free sources or free tests, then you can refer to this website or you can check for other sources of free tests on Google. Now I will be sharing with you the study pattern which I followed to be useful and efficient to prepare for exam in 7 weeks. This will be a progressive pattern where you will start with basic steps by each coming week and you will level up to increase the difficulty and ultimately be prepared enough to appear for the exam. Starting with week 1, you can pick up a course and start learning. Also, you can optionally do hands-on and make sure to take short notes, which will come handy later at the time of revision. Continue with this learning for 2 more weeks so that you make sure to complete the course and some of the hands-on you think might help you to understand the concepts. Now, how does 3 weeks of time make sure that your fundamentals are ready? If you allot 1 hour daily on weekdays after your office and 4 hours daily on weekends, that is each on Saturday and Sunday, you'll get 13 hours per week, that is 39 hours for 3 weeks. And for most of the courses, the duration for the course is 15 to 20 hours long. So you get enough buffer time to understand theory and practice and you won't run out of time. Now for the 4th week, start with easy tests and gradually try to score up to 85% in these tests. These easy tests can be the sample tests provided by AWS or the online free tests available. You can also finish up the course in case it is incomplete, but try to finish this course in this 4th week. For 5th and 6th week, your target should be the first revision of what you have learned so far. Start with difficult tests and try to aim for at least 65%. Also, aim to read FAQs and white papers which are recommended as they are also important from exam point of view. And for the final week, that is 7th week, aim to revise theory and notes as this would be your second and final revision. And try to score at least 70 to 75% in the difficult test. Also, you can spend time in reading FAQs and white papers. If you follow such kind of study pattern, you will be in a position to appear for the exam in at least 7 weeks. You can also make some changes to this pattern as per your requirements. Now coming to the motivation, then don't worry if you are not able to cross 65 to 75% in test, as this happens with most of people in the beginning. This has also happened with me. Initially, people usually get less score and most of them get demotivated. But don't worry, don't give up and keep giving as much test as possible till you reach at least 70% in difficult test. Usually, when you will get incorrect answers, try to understand what are the sections where you are weak and try to work on these weaknesses. Gradually, as you keep on trying and keep on giving tests, you will remember the concepts, you will understand what is exactly your weak area, and based on that, you will learn from your mistakes and gradually your score will increase. And all I can say is, keep trying, try till you succeed. Please subscribe to channel Skill Philip, press the bell icon, like this video and share this video with all of your friends. All the best for your AWS journey.